Hey, hi guys, Mike here, one go ShortPlay, from the messy office, a state in which it will stay until after Christmas, because who has time? Who has time? So today, I had a little dig through my iPhone, because I knew the footage was there somewhere, at my last days at the school I worked at, in which I created that games arcade, and I wanted to show you it. I mean, you've seen it half finished and not up and running. But I wanted to show you the thing actually finished and up and running. You'll notice, disclaimer, I was a bit gutted to find it when I looked at the footage because I'd completely forgotten about it, that the Dreamcast appears to be broke. The Dreamcast is not broke. It was just the telly that the Dreamcast's hooked up to is broke. It's not now. I've since tried to fix it, failed, and replaced it. So a bit of a shame that the Dreamcast's not running there. So I've got, cold. All the beginnings of one, I think, which is really annoying because I've got another week at work and I've got stuff to do, you know, stuff I want to get done, deadlines and whatnot, and I'm going to meet them regardless of the state of physical fitness. And also the footage goes a bit funny. I basically ran out of battery halfway round, as you do, on an old iPhone, and had to charge up and carry on. So you'll notice there's a bit of a jump when we hit the Xbox. Yeah, a bit of a pain. It's an Xbox. I wanted to be a bit more thorough than that. But hey, it is what it is. I got what I managed to get. Yeah, as I say, I worked at this school for 2 years. I had this retro game arcade set up at quite early in the first year in a different part of the school. I think the new place I put it the second time suits it much better. As I mentioned, the school is a media school. It doesn't have playgrounds and whatnot for the students, secondary students, to just chill out in. They were hanging around the corridors a lot, they were getting in the way a lot, and they weren't very comfortable in their environment, so it was one of the many reasons, and the fact that it's a digital media school and they want to learn about making games and they want to learn about old games, the many reasons behind it, but one of them was that there wasn't any space for the kids, so I made some, and I made it as useful and as educational as possible for them. So this was it. I left the school for my own reasons. One, it's too far. Basically, there was a lot of demand from above, and it went beyond being worth it. Let's put it that way. The thing I was most afraid of when I started there was the kids, and the thing that I missed the most when I left there was the kids. They were the best thing about it. I won't say they're the only good thing about it, but there wasn't much else to keep me there. Bit of a shame, but I think this little legacy, I'm hoping, is still alive there. And if it's not, let's record it for history. Of course, there's no students using this. You don't film students at a school. It's not done. Unless you're the school. So this is it when it was quiet, before anyone got in there. Just before anyone got in there. You'll notice there's a few schoolboy errors. The Commodore 64 tape deck. Mark, you'll see that. And this was before I knew better, basically. Without further ado, welcome to the dungeon. there it is. That was the dungeon. That was my little games arcade I created for a school. I was very pleased with it. It cost about £5,000. A lot of my friends donated kit, which was brilliant of them. I donated a couple of bits. It has enough for its first year of running, I think. What it needs now is more games. Whether they will support that and keep doing that, I don't know. I'd have pushed for it, but I think it would have fallen on deaf ears. So I'm hopeful that someone there will recognise that and do something with it and keep it going and make it bigger and better. That was always my plan, to keep involving it. I did to an extent, and that was the extent, as you saw. Not bad. I drew all the graphics myself and built up the little story around the sides of the room. You might have noticed that. Just to keep it interesting, you don't want a room full of bare walls, really. Yeah, the game's consoles are the main feature, but at the end of the day, it's got the whole thing is a feature for the kids. So I wanted to take the opportunity to educate them a little bit, but not doing it in a patronising way that gives them a wall of text and history about consoles. Yeah, it's a bit patronising to do it through characters, but they appreciated the work, I think, that went into those characters and went into my keeping it minimal. I'm proud of that. It's one of the many things I'm proud of. It's gone now, it's history now. I just wanted to preserve it while I could. That was the dungeon. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope the kids are still enjoying it. Thanks for watching.